reporting for Kids First, and today I have the pleasure to sit down with Elena Smith, creator of the hit show Dickinson. Smith is known for her work on The Affair. Now let's talk to her about her work on Dickinson.
Hi, I'm Heather with Kids First.
Hi.
Hi, Elena. It's so nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
So I have to get right into it. Dickinson is such a creative, wonderful show. It's the perfect mix between period drama and modern comedy. How did you get this idea? Where did it come about? And what was it like to finally being able to film it?
Well, I got the idea for the show. I guess I was interested in Emily Dickinson way back when I was in high school reading her poetry. Then right when I graduated from college, I read a biography of hers that I really resonated with, and learning more about the actual person who wrote those poems, I was fascinated by her life story and its sort of profound ironies, the fact that, you know, she wrote about such big subjects in such tiny little lines, or that she managed to capture so much depth of experience, even though it seems like she barely ever left her house. And of course, the greatest irony of all about Emily, which is that, you know, she was not understood or appreciated in her own time. And so all those things stuck with me, as well as her brilliant work. And I think it was probably 10 years after that that I found myself in Los Angeles. I had been a playwright. I was out there trying to be a television writer, trying to think of original ideas for shows. And I just had this crazy idea to have a half hour comedy about Emily Dickinson. And then I just worked on it and worked on it and wrote the pilot, and then got to sell it to Apple and gone on this whole long journey, which is now wrapping up with season 3.
That's absolutely incredible. I mean, a 10-year journey. What was the audition process like? I mean, you've had this idea for 10 years, and now to finally see it come to life, what was it like picking all these actors to make sure that they brought justice to your vision?
Well, you know, because I started in theater, I had plenty of experience with casting and with finding, you know, the right people for the right characters. And in fact, with Dickinson, we also draw a lot on the New York theater community for our casting. So there were a number of actors that I, you know, already was familiar with. Anna Baryshnikov and I were friends. I knew, you know, different. I mean, obviously Haley was just a force to be reckoned with, and was already our Emily Dickinson, who we were writing the show sort of towards. And then it was a question of finding the other people to fill the roles. And I think with casting, there's just kind of this magical thing that happens where when you see them, you know, like when I saw Toby Huss, I said, that's Edward, and I don't want anybody else to be Edward. And it's just about his face and his vibe. And so it was an adventure finding people, but I mean, we, like, these are the Dickinsons to me. Nobody else could ever be them. And it feels so incredible.
I talked to Ella and Adrian, and they're just such amazing people. And when you get to know them, it's like, oh, I understand why they were cast as these amazing characters. And you get to have such a love for them after years of working on this show. What was it like to finally say goodbye to them and wrapping up the show?
You know, bittersweet, obviously, although I, you know, hope and expect that I will get to work with, you know, a lot of people that have been involved with Dickinson again in other projects and other ways. And obviously we've all become really close, and we will stay in each other's lives. You know, honestly, it was just such a joy to get to write for this brilliant young cast and watch them grow in their roles. I mean, Ella is somebody who in each year of this show has had to do something different, and has just trusted me and worked with me to build this very layered, complex character that is Sue. I mean, mostly I'm just really proud of them and excited to see what they do next.
That's absolutely incredible. I mean, like you said, Ella has had to do a bunch of different things that wouldn't naturally happen in this era of time, which is so fun. What was your favorite scene to film? Like, I love the scene when Sue and Emily dress up as guys and they go to the club. I think that was so funny. What was your favorite scene to film?
Oh, that's awesome. I don't have a favorite because there's not one single second of Dickinson that I haven't been fully emotionally invested in. So, you know, I can't pick a favorite, but I will say that there was something pretty special about shooting that final scene with Haley on the beach when I was directing the final episode. And she is in Emily's white dress. And it was the most beautiful day. We were all outside after having shot the whole thing during the pandemic. And it was the greatest release and joy that I felt in that moment. So
I feel like it really went, you see her character development. And then in that scene, it's like she finally, wearing that dress in particular, is like she finally became who she wanted to be.
Yes, exactly. And this whole show has been the origin story of America's greatest female poet. And that dress is like her superhero costume that she gets to put on at the end. So.
She reaches her happy ending. And so speaking of that dress, it's one of the most amazing props from the series. Knowing that it was the last season, did you take anything from set?
It's funny that you asked that because I did keep that dress.
Oh, well, it's in good hands.
Yeah.
That's amazing. And I can't wait to see how everyone, the audiences, react to this show. It was an adventure watching it. I've laughed so much. And then I cried at the end because it was like, it's over. And you don't want it to be over, but it was a perfect ending. Thank you so
Thank
much.
Thank you for so much. About. And I so appreciate your time. And I'm excited for everyone to see it too.
Thank you so much. It was so great meeting you guys. Thank you. Bye.
Dickinson Season 3 premieres November 5th only on Apple TV Plus. I'm Heather reporting for Kids First, and thank you for watching. Be sure to subscribe to our channel to get all of our newest reviews, and I'll see you guys soon. Bye!
But your situation, you're not a child anymore.